Good morning, everyone. So in this class, I am going to start steady state analysis of control system. That's nothing but firstly, we are going to see the steady state error. Okay. So steady state error. Here. Steady state error is the value of error signal, okay, and that is e of t is the error signal. So when t tends to infinite, see the figure, that is 3.17, and this is a closed loop system with negative feedback. So here R of s is my input and C of s is the output of the system, G of s is the open loop gain, and H of s is the feedback path gain. Okay, see, we are considering a closed loop system here. So nothing but here C of s, product of C of s, H of s, that is the feedback signal, right? So E of s is the error signal, so which is the difference between R of s and the feedback signal, that is C of s multiplied with H of s. Okay, see, simply steady state error nothing but the error signal E of t when it tends to infinity. Error signal E of t tends to infinity. So simply that is the steady state error. Okay. So steady state error is used to measure the system accuracy. So these errors arise from the nature of inputs and type of the system, and from the non-linearity of the system components. So mainly depend upon these parameters, so the errors may arises. Okay, the steady state performance of a stable control system is generally judged by its steady state error by giving a step, ramp, and parabolic inputs. Here we have E of s equal to R of s minus, here from the figure, E of s equal to R of s minus the feedback one, that is simply here you substitute C of s from equation 3.57 in 5.6. Okay, so that is E of s equal to R of s minus C of s into H of s, right? So now substitute C of s, we know C of s equal to E of s into G of s, right? So now substitute that C of s value in 3.56. So finally we have E of s equal to R of s minus product of E of s, G of s, and H of s. So that is the value of E of s. Okay. Now the next equation, E of s plus E of s into G of s into H of s, that equal to R of s. Okay. So simply common E of s term, so we have 1 plus G of s into H of s, that equal to R of s. So therefore E of s equal to R of s divided by 1 plus G of s into H of s. See, this is the error signal in S domain. We know E of t is the error signal in T domain. So in order to find out in T domain, applying inverse Laplace transform. Okay. So we are going to apply inverse Laplace transform to the 3.56 equation. So 5.8 equation. See, from the definition, steady state error nothing but its value of error signal et when t tends to infinity, right? So that's why here the steady state error is defined as the value of et when t tends to infinity. So this is the ess. Steady state error is denoted as ess. So simply ess is nothing but value of et when t tends to infinity. So that's why I'm going to write equation number 3.60, that is e of ss equal to limit t tends to infinity e of t. Okay, from the final value theorem of Laplace transform, so it states that limit t tends to infinity f of t, that equal to, so here I'm considering in time domain, okay, that is limit t tends to infinity f of t is equal to limit s tends to 0 s into fs in s domain. So by using the final value theorem, the steady state error, that is ess, equal to limit t tends to infinity e of t, that equal to simply applying and by taking the final value theorem, by using the final value theorem, here we are going to rewrite the equation, that is 3.59. so that is limit s tends to 0 s into e of s, okay, that equal to limit s tends to 0 s into r of s by 1 plus g of s into h of s. Okay, this is the steady state error value, that is ess, which is equal to limit s tends to 0 s into r of s by 1 plus g of s into h of s. See, the next one is type number of control systems. Here, type number is mainly specified for a loop transfer function. That is, loop transfer function means g of s multiplied with h of s. Here, the number of poles of loop transfer function lying at the origin, okay, are nothing but the number of poles of loop transfer function which exist at origin. They will decide the type number of the system. Okay, here see, here n is the number of poles at the origin, then the type is simply called as n. Here we are considering the loop transfer function, so that can be expressed as a ratio of two polynomials. See equation number 3.55, that is g of s into h of s. It is the loop transfer function, that is equal to k into p of s by q of s, nothing but k into s plus z1, s plus z2, s plus z3 and so on, divided by s power n into s plus p1 into s plus p2 and so on. Okay, see here z1, z2, z3 and so on, they are the zeros of transfer function, and p1, p2, p3, they are the poles of the transfer function. See, simply z1, z2, z3 are the zeros of the transfer function. They are zeros of the transfer function are simply find out by equating s plus z1 to 0. So simply we have first zero value. So in order to calculate the zeros values, we have to equate the term s plus z1 equal to 0 and s plus z2 equal to 0 and so on. Similarly, in order to find out the poles of the transfer function also, we have to equate the denominator term, that is s plus p1 equal to 0 and s plus p2 equal to 0 and so on. Okay, in order to find out the values of zeros and poles, we equate the terms, that is numerator term or denominator term. In order to find out the respective zeros or poles, we have to equate the term to 0. Okay, and where k is the constant and n is the number of poles at the origin. See, type number of the control system is mainly the number of poles at origin, right? So in order to find out the type number of control system, we have to look the single S term power in the denominator of the transfer function, right? See, here equation 3.55, see the denominator, there is a single S term having the root, that is N. So simply we can say it is a N type number, okay. See, the value of N in the denominator polynomial of loop transfer function, which decides the type number of the system. If N equal to 0, then the system is type 0 system. If the N is 1, so simply it is a type 1 system. If it is 2, then we call it type 2 system. If it is 3, then simply it is a type 3 system, and so on. So that is, you just keep in mind that we have to identify the single S term root in the denominator of the transfer function. So the value, the root of the single S term in the denominator will decide the type number of that system. See, the next one is static error constants. Just wait. See, there are mainly three types of static error constants. One is the positional error constant and velocity error constant, and third one is acceleration error constant. Okay, KP, KV, and KA. They are called as static error constants. Okay. Here, when a control system is excited with a standard input signal, so then the steady state error, that is your ESS, okay, steady state error ESS may be constant or equal to 0 or infinity, okay. See, if the control system is a type 0 system, then the system will have a constant ESS when the input is a step signal. So that constant is called as positional error constant. So we that is simply denoted as Kp. So Kp equal to limit S tends to 0 G of S into H of S. Okay. If type 1 system will have constant steady state error, that is ESS, when the input signal is a ramp signal, so then the constant is called as velocity error constant, which is denoted as KV. So KV equal to limit S tends to 0 limit S tends to 0 S into G of S multiplied with H of S. If type 2 system will have constant steady state error, when the input signal is a parabolic signal, so then the constant is simply called as acceleration error constant, that is Ka. So Ka equal to limit S tends to 0 S square into G of S multiplied with H of S. Okay, so simply static error coefficients, nothing but when the system is excited, the standard input signal, simply a steady state error may be a constant or zero infinity. The system is a type zero system. Simply the constant is called as position error constant. Type 1 system will have constant ESS. Simply the constant is called as velocity error constant. If type 2 system will have a constant steady state error ESS for parabolic signal, so then the constant is called as acceleration error constant. So for type 0 input is step signal, so the constant is position error constant. For type 1, ES is constant for ramp input signal. So that's why that constant we call it velocity error constant, KV. For type 2 system, input is when input is parabolic signal, then the constant is called as simply acceleration error constant, that is KA. See, KP, KV and KA are called as static error constants. See, and the next one is steady state error for unit step input. That's nothing but here we are going to derive the steady state error when the input is a unit step signal. See, we know that steady state error, that is ESS equal to limit S tends to 0, S into R of S by 1 plus GS HS, G of S into H of S, right? See, okay. So here by using the final value theorem, we have the steady state error, that is ESS equal to limit S, limit t tends to infinity et, that equal to limit s tends to 0 s into r of s by 1 plus g of s into h of s. Okay, so this is the steady state error. Here our topic is we are going to find out the steady state error for the unit step input. Okay, so that's why initially I'm going to write the steady state error, that is ESS equal to limit S tends to 0 S into R of S by 1 plus G of S into H of S. So we are considering the unit step input, right? So it's a transformation, it is R of S. So initially here I'm taking the unit step input, right? But steady state error ESS equal to limit S tends to 0 S into R of S by 1 plus G of S into H of S. So all these terms in S domain. So that's why I'm considering the Laplace transformation for my input, that is a unit step. So its transformation becomes R of S equal to 1 by S. So substitute the value of R of S in steady state error. So ESS equal to limit S tends to 0 S into, so substitute the R of S value, so 1 by S by 1 plus G of S into H of S. So simply cancel both S terms in the numerator. Finally, we have limit S tends to 0 1 by 1 plus G of S into H of S. So applying limit to the term, so simply it becomes 1 by 1 plus limit T, limit S tends to 0 G of S into H of S, right? See, limit S tends to 0 G of S into H of S. Just before we are seeing limit S tends to 0 G of S into H of S, nothing but positional error constant, right? So KP, so simply replace the, substitute the value of KP, that is 1 by 1 plus KP. Just replace the term, that is limit S tends to 0 G of S into H of S by KP, because that is equal to positional, see, that is positional error constant KP. So substitute Kp in that term, that is limit s tends to 0 or g of s into h of s. So that the constant Kp is called positional error constant. For type 0 system, so we know Kp equal to limit s tends to 0 g of s into h of s. Here see limit s tends to 0 k into s plus z1 s plus z2 and so on to so on divided by s plus p1 s plus p2 and s plus p3 and so on. It simply which is equal to k into, so the numerator which indicates the zeros, the denominator indicates the poles, right? So k into z1 z2 z3 and so on divided by p1 p2 p3, so which is equal to constant. That's nothing but ESS, so steady state error, that is equal to 1 by 1 plus kp. See, 1 by 1 plus kp. Here, type 0 system, when we apply applying the input, that is unit step, so there will be a constant steady state error, right? Here, limit s tends to 0. So g of s into h of s. What is g of s into h of s? See, g of s into h of s nothing but it is the loop transfer function, right? So that is k into s plus z1, s plus z2, s plus z3 and so on by divided by s power n into s plus p1, s plus p2 and so on. So simply write that in, just simply substitute the value of g of s h of s here. So in the denominator s power n, so here s tends to 0, the term here, the term is simply constant, so 1. Okay, for type 1 system, that is Kp equal to limit s tends to 0 g of s into h of s. Okay, so limit s tends to 0 k into s plus z1, so simply substitute the loop transfer function. Okay, that is g of s into h of s nothing but k into p of s by q of s in this equation. Here in the term, that is Kp equal to limit s tends to 0 g of s into h of s. So we have limit s tends to 0 k into s plus z1 s plus z2 and s plus z3 and so on divided by s into, here we have s term because it is type 1 system. For type 1 system, in the denominator we have a single s have the power 1. For type 0 system, here s power 0, right? So s power 0 means simply 1 constant. So that's why here in type 0 system, here in the denominator we don't have single s value because it is a type 0 system, but here it is type 1 system. That's why here we have s power 1. Okay. See, applying simple substitute the limit, that is s tends to 0. Here we will get Kp, which is equal to infinity, right? So ESS is equal to 1 by 1 plus Kp, which is equal to 1 by 1 plus infinity, so simply equal to 0. Here the systems with type 1 and above, for unit step input, the value of Kp is infinity. So the steady state error is जीरो, सी कमिंग टू नेक्स्ट वन, देयर इज स्टेडी स्टेट एरर व्हेन द इनपुट इज यूनिट रैंप सिग्नल. So here we are going to applying, we are going to consider the input signal that is a unit ramp signal. So that's why taking steady state error that is ESS equal to limit S tends to 0 S into R of S by 1 plus J of S into H of S, right? See here the term, see here the steady state error ESS we are consider in S domain, so that's why here also I am taking the transformed version of the input, that is R of S, which is equal to 1 by RAM signal is Laplace transformed version, that is R of S, which is equal to 1 by S square, right? Okay. So simply substitute the value of R of S in the steady state error expression, that is ESS equal to limit S tends to 0. S into 1 by S square divided by 1 plus G of S into H of S, right? So simply cancel S and S square. So we have S in the numerator. See 1 by S in the numerator. So S is equal to limit S tends to 0. 1 by S into 1 plus G of S into H of S, right? Simply applying the limit for that equation. Okay. So simply applying S tends to 0 in this expression. So we have 0 plus limit S tends to 0, J of S into H of S, right? So see here ES is equal to 1 by limit S tends to 0, S into J of S multiplied with H of S, right? So finally, this term which denotes the KV, velocity error constant. So ES is equal to 1 by limit S tends to 0, S into J of S into H of S, right? So that equal to 1 by KV, where KV is the velocity error constant. That is ES is equal to 1 by KV. So for type 0 system, we know that velocity error constant KV equal to limit S tends to 0, S into J of S into H of S, right? So that equal to limit S tends to 0, S into, substitute the open loop transfer function value, that is K into P by Q form, that is zeros by poles, that is S into S plus Z1, S plus Z2, S plus Z3 and so on, divided by S power N into S plus P1, S plus P2 and S plus P3. So simply for a type 0 system, the value of single S term root is 0 for type 0 system. So S power 0 means 1. So simply I'm going to write limit S tends to 0, S into K, S plus Z1, S plus Z2, S plus Z3 and so on, divided by S plus P1 into S plus P2 into and so on. Okay, so applying the limit that is s tends to 0, so the entire term, that is the entire loop transfer function, that is g of s, h of s, is multiplied with 0. So finally we have the velocity error constant, that is kv equal to 0. Okay, so steady state error ess equal to 1 by kv, that equal to substitute the kv value. So ess equal to 1 by 0, which is equal to infinity. That is steady state error for ramp input, which is equal to infinite for type 0 system. For type 1, considering the velocity error constant, there is kv equal to limit s tends to 0 s into g of s h of s, right? So kv equal to limit s tends to 0 k into s into, so substitute the value, that is a loop transfer function, g of s into h of s, nothing but k into s plus z1, s plus z2 and s plus z3 divided by s into s plus p1 into s plus p2 and so on. Here we are considering type 1 system, so that's why we are having a single s term in the denominator having the root 1, because it is a type 1 system. If it is a type 2 system, then the single s term in the denominator of the transfer function have the root 2, having the root 2. Okay, so here we are taking type 1 system, that's why the denominator, so this the single s term in the denominator having the root, that is 1. Okay, single s term. So that's why we have velocity error constant, that is kv equal to limit s tends to 0 k into s, then s plus z1 multiplied with s plus z2 multiplied with s plus z3 and so on, divided by s into s plus p1 and s plus p2 and so on. So now applying the limit, that is s tends to 0, so substitute simply s equal to 0, that is kv equal to k into, here we have both numerator and denominator s term get cancelled, so finally we have k into z1, z2, z3 divided by p1, p2, p3. So nothing but it's a constant value. So the steady state error for ramp input, so that is ess equal to 1 by kv. We are already getting, that is kv equal to, we already have kv equal to constant value. So simply steady state error, that is ess equal to 1 by kv. So that is 1 by constant. So the final value of steady state error, which is also a constant. Okay. See here, next type 2 system. For type 2 system, we are going to derive the steady state error. See, you know velocity error constant, that is kv equal to limit s tends to 0 s into g of s into h of s, right? So substitute here also, same substitute the loop transfer function g of s and h of s value, that is k into s plus z1, s plus z2 and so on to s power 2, because the single s term root should be 2 for type 2 system. Okay, so applying the limit as same as previous, so finally kv, which is equal to infinite, so the steady state error ess equal to 1 by kv, so 1 by infinity nothing but 0. So from this we conclude that in a system So type 2 and above, for ramp input, the value of KV is infinite. Okay, so the value of KV is infinite. That's why the steady state error, so ESS, is equal to 0. Okay. See. And the next topic is steady state error when the input is unit parabolic signal. So here also we are going to derive the steady state error ESS for input for unit parabolic signal. Unit parabolic signal input by taking the unit parabolic signal as the input. Okay, so we know steady state error, that is ESS equal to limit S tends to 0 S into R of S by 1 plus G of S into H of S, right? So R of S is nothing but it is the reference signal. Here my reference nothing but input. Okay, my input signal is unit parabolic signal. So R of S means it's a transformed version. So that's why I'm taking transformed version of my input, that is R of S, which is equal to 1 by S cube. So substitute the value of R of S in the steady state error. Okay, so simply ESS equal to limit S tends to 0 1 by, so there is nothing but in the numerator we have S into 1 by S cube. So cancel S and S cube. So we have 1 by S square in the numerator by divided by the denominator term, that is 1 plus G of S into H of S, right? So applying the limit value, that is S tends to 0. So substituting S equal to 0, then we have the final value, that is ESS equal to 1 by KA. Okay. See, before that, before 1 by KA, just see, ESS equal to 1 by limit S tends to 0. Here S square plus S square into G of S multiplied with HFS, right? So applying limit, that is S tends to 0, S square term will be 0. Okay, and the next term is 1 by limit S tends to 0, S square multiplied with G of S and HFS, right? The entire term can be written as acceleration error constant, that is KA. So ESS equal to steady state error ESS equal to 1 by KA. You know that KA is limit S tends to 0, S square into G of S, H of S. Okay. So for type 0 system, we are going to derive the steady state error. So in order to derive the steady state error, first we have to know the KA value, that is acceleration error constant. So for type 0, we are going to find out the acceleration error coefficient KA. See, KA equal to limit S tends to 0, S square into G of S into H of S. So G of S into H of S means it's a loop transfer function. So simply substitute G of S into H of S. Value, that is the loop transfer function, that is K into P of S by R of S. See. Okay, so G of S into H of S equal K into P of S by Q of S. Sorry, not R of S, Q of S. So that is K into S plus Z1, S plus Z2, and so on, divided by S power N into S plus P1, and so on. So this is the loop transfer function in terms of a ratio of two polynomials. So here we are considering this loop transfer function. See, and then applying the limit value, that is s tends to 0. So while applying s tends to 0, we have ESS, so that is equal to, you know that ESS is equal to 1 by k, right? So the, while applying, see, applying limit s tends to 0, the value of ka becomes 0, right? So simply ESS, which is equal to 1 by 0. This is nothing but infinite. Similarly, we are going to find out the ESS value for type 1 and type 2 and also type 3 systems. So for type 1, we have ESS equal to infinity. For type 2, the steady state error is constant. For type 3, steady state error is equal to 0. So simply we are going to conclude that systems with type number 3 and above, for unit parabolic input, the value of Ka is infinity. So the value of Ka is infinity, then the steady state error is simply equal to 0. So this is the two tabular forms for static error constant for various type number of systems, as well as the second tabular is about steady state error for various type of inputs. See, error constants, that is Kp, Kv and Ka, for various type number of systems, that is 0, type 0 system, type 1 system, type 2 system and type 3 system. For type 0, Kp is constant. For type 1, Kv is constant. For type 2, Ka is constant. Here also, for unit step, type 0, the steady state error, that is 1 by 1 plus Kp. For type 1 system, for input unit ramp signal, the steady state error, which is equal to 1 by Kv. Similarly, for type 2 system, unit parabolic input signal, steady state error value 1 by Ka. See, thank you.